Good morning, everybody, and happy Friday. Today is Friday, January 29th, and here are the announcements for today. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please pause for a moment of silence. Thank you. You may be seated. Well, we have some people celebrating today and over the weekend. We want to wish a happy birthday today to Gabriela Linares and Dylan Rodriguez. And celebrating over the weekend, we have Miss Magarino, Miss Williams, and Mr. Villegas. So happy birthday to you all. And here's the news from Dr. Lopez's Nest.
Good morning, Wise Owls, and happy Friday. I was kind of hoping that our 98% would stick, but no, we actually went down from 98% to 97%. But hopefully we'll go back and enjoy another day with 98% very soon. Classes with 100% attendance. In pre-K, we had Ms. Ferdinand. In kindergarten, we had Ms. Blanco, Ms. D. Garcia, Ms. Garcia Iñiguez. In first grade, we had Ms. Cruz, Ms. Houston, Ms. Monroe. In second grade, we had Ms. Houston, Ms. Monroe, Ms. Rubio, Ms. Savin Baker. In third grade, we had Ms. Clement, Ms. Sanchez, Ms. Tassie, and Ms. Vidal. In fourth grade, we had Ms. Patino and Ms. X Perez. And in fifth grade, we had Ms. Antigua, Ms. Ferguson, Mr. Cheney, Ms. Cullen, and Ms. P. Rodriguez. We had a full house in fifth grade. So congratulations to all those classes. We hope to see more classes on our list on Monday so that maybe we can get another day with 98% or higher. As a reminder, boys and girls, because we had 98% attendance yesterday, we do have a no uniform day on Monday, February 1st. So when we come back from the weekend, you don't have to wear your uniform, but always remember, boys and girls, you still need to dress appropriately for school, which means no leggings, no ripped jeans, nothing that is not appropriate. And I think most of you know what is and what is not appropriate by now. Those are all my announcements for today. I hope all of you enjoy our Literature in the Park day. Have a wonderful weekend. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Lopez. Yes, today is our virtual Literature in the Park day. I want to say a big thank you to all of the teachers who took the time. I know even till last night you were recording and re-recording. I really appreciated teachers. And I know our kids are going to appreciate it too. Thank you for going the extra mile and being an amazing reader for our Literature in the Park today. And I encourage everyone, it's a beautiful day. It's a little chilly out, but bundle up and just go outside and read today. At some point today, go outside, read a book to yourself. Maybe teachers can take their kids out and read a story to them. I don't know. Just have some fun. Go outside and read today. It's Literature in the Park day. And tonight is our last bedtime story of the week. I hope you've enjoyed them. They've been posted on our Facebook page and also in our Oliver Hoover Media Center team. If you missed any, you can go back and watch them. They're still there. And parents, don't forget to apply for free and reduced lunch. do that through the parent portal, or there is also a link on our website. Very important. And calling all four-year-olds, we are registering kids for our VPK program. The registration is open until February 25th. Stop by the main office at the main campus to register 8:30 to 12:30 or 2 o'clock to 3:30 p.m. And looking ahead to next week, we have some more incredible parent workshops coming. Next week, the focus is on helping your child focus. It will be in English on Tuesday, Creole on Wednesday, and Spanish on Thursday. So take a look at that. And my Celebrate Literacy Week fact of the day today is there's no such thing as a kid who hates reading. There are kids who love reading and kids who are reading the wrong books. So true. If you don't love reading, try to find some kind of a book that you do like. There's funny books, there's graphic novels, there's mysteries, there's biographies, there's science fiction, there's nonfiction. There's so many things to choose from. So if you don't love reading, it's because you're reading the wrong books. Me and James Patterson say so. And we cannot go today without saying a very special wish to our Miss Gomez. Miss Gomez, our second grade teacher, is retiring today after spending 41 years teaching, and 28 of those years were spent here at Oliver Hoover. Miss Gomez, we are going to miss you so. We hope you know how much we all love you. Miss Aguilar and Dr. Lopez recorded a message for you, but something happened with the Flipgrid. I don't know. I'm sure they're going to come by and say it themselves. But Miss Gomez, from me and from all of your colleagues and all of the students you've had over all of these 41 years, thank you for all you've done for us, for your students. We will miss you, but we wish you all the best on your new adventure. Happy retirement, Miss Gomez. And here's my Friday feel for you today. Happiness does not depend on what happens outside of you, but what happens inside of you. Happiness comes from the inside. Wishing you all the happiest of Fridays. Happy retirement, Miss Gomez, and happy literature in the park to everyone, and have a wonderful weekend.